British official secretary sent a message to the Maharaja that the Durai, that is the official himself, did not want to kill the tiger. The king could kill the tiger. He only wanted to get himself photographed with the dead body of a tiger. But the king did not agree to this proposal also. He said that if he relaxed his decision and allowed the official to get himself photographed with the dead tiger, then the other British officers would also come to Pratibandhapuram in order to fulfill their wish of hunting a tiger. As the king had refused a British officer from fulfilling his wish, he was in danger of losing his kingdom. The king had discussion with his ministers over the issue. The king sent a telegram to a famous British company of jewelers based in Calcutta. He asked them to send samples of expensive diamond rings of different designs. Dear students, India was ruled by Britishers, and though he was the king of Pratibandhapuram, yet he had to fear the British officials. Going against the Britishers meant losing his kingdom. So in order to please his wife, he had sent for the jeweler in Calcutta. The jeweler sent 50 rings and the Maharaja sent all of them to the British officer's wife. He wanted to please her in order to make good the damage that he had done by refusing the official. The king had expected that the British officer's wife would choose one out of so many rings. But she just sent a reply saying thanks for the gifts and kept all the rings. After 2 days, the British jeweler sent a bill of 3 lakh rupees for the 50 diamond rings that they had sent. That means he had to pay a huge amount of money for refusing the British official to get his photograph clicked with a dead tiger. The Maharaja was happy that he had saved his kingdom for a sum of 3 lakh rupees. The king was very successful in his tiger hunting missions. In a span of 10 years, he had killed 70 tigers. My dear students, he was quite near to go against the prophecy of the astrologer that it is the 100th tiger who would kill him. He had now killed about 70 tigers. An unplanned problem stopped his mission. The problem was that there was no more tigers in Pratibandhapuram. The writer creates humor when he says that maybe the tigers practiced birth control activities and did not produce offsprings. Or maybe they committed suicide. Committed suicide, why? Because they didn't want to be killed by Jang Jang Bahadur. He also adds that it could be that they ran away from Pratibandhapuram because they did not want to be killed by an Indian. And on the other hand, they wanted to be killed by a Britisher. Again, the humor is there that even the animals very well knew that the Indians were dominated by the Britishers. One day the king called his minister and waved his gun towards him. He said that he was yet to kill 30 more tigers. He was so eager that he wanted to kill the tigers, and that was the reason he was not looking into the state affairs. The minister was scared when he saw the gun, and he cried to the king that he was not a tiger, as he feared that the king might aim his gun at him. Again, the writer creates a humor telling that even the officials, they were so much frightened of the king that they did everything that the king wanted them to do. The king said that he was not foolish, that he would mistake the minister for a tiger. In one way, he was making fun of the minister, that he was not at all as brave as a tiger. The minister was so scared that he added that he was neither a gun. The king said to him that he knew that he was neither a tiger nor a gun. But on the other hand, the king had called his minister for another work. The king wanted to get married. The minister was so confused that he started speaking something in a silly way. Now this really shows that when you come in front of a very top-notch autocratic ruler, what happened to the official or to the masses? He said that the king already had 2 wives, and if the if the minister, he said that the king already had two wives, and if the minister married the king. The king interrupted the minister and scolded him for speaking nonsense. He said that he had no reason to marry the minister and he did not want to marry him. He said that he wanted a tiger. So the writer again creates humor when he says that the minister told the king that he should think over his decision. The minister adds that the king's ancestors were married to the sword, and so if he wanted, he could marry the gun. But marrying a tiger and getting a tiger queen for the kingdom of Pratibandhapuram was not a good thought. He added that a tiger king was enough for the state, and they did not require a tiger queen.